الحمد لله رب العالمين، والصلاة والسلام على نبينا محمد وعلى آله وأصحابه. أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله. ما بعد، فإن أصدق الحديث كتاب الله، خير الهدي هدي نبينا محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم، وشر الأمور محدثاتها، كل محدثة بدعة، كل بدعة ضلالة، وكل ضلالة في النار. إن شاء الله tonight we'll talk about the book of Allah سبحانه وتعالى، القرآن. And the word علوم القرآن. Okay, the sciences of the Quran related to the Quran. Also, this includes the tafsir. يعني علوم القرآن, we mention علوم القرآن. This includes anything related to the Quran. تجويد, تفسير, ناسخ, منسوخ. طيب. Okay, تنوير. Maybe you need to change position, or now it's okay. خلاص. طيب. So علوم القرآن. This science talks about everything related to the Quran. And especially in this month, the month of the Quran, Allah سبحانه وتعالى revealed the Quran in this month, شهر رمضان الذي أنزل فيه القرآن. So it is very important to study the things related to the Quran. Because sometimes people say, well, people think that I am Muslim, I know Arabic, I can understand the Quran, no problem. I read and I can get the point from the Quran. This is wrong. You should know what are the rules to understand the Quran. This is very, very important. طيب. So let's talk about the Quran, the book of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, or the sciences of the Quran. So the first thing we like to mention, the definition of the Quran. ما معنى القرآن أو تعريف القرآن؟ القرآن okay, اصطلاحا كلام الله المنزل بالعربية على محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم، منقول إلينا بالتواتر، المتعبد بتلاوته، شكرا، المعجز المبدوء بالفاتحة إلى الناس، غير مخلوق. طيب. You know, sometimes you find the scholars adding one word, maybe you wonder what is the point to add this? No need. But they add it in the definition because of some of the deviant sects. So the word غير مخلوق, the time of the companions, they don't have any problem with the issue that Quran, the book of Allah, the words of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. But later, during the time for Imam Ahmad rahimahullah ta'ala, the big problem happened. The Muslim Ummah, the ruler forced people to say that Quran is created. And this is wrong, because we should believe the Quran is the book of the words of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So that's why they add the word غير مخلوق, not created. طيب, again. So what is the definition of Quran? Number one, كلام الله. It is the words of Allah. So this is the first thing we mentioned. It is not the words of the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم. And it is not a word of شاعر, the one who says poetry and these things. وما هو بقول شاعر. Allah سبحانه وتعالى negated that. وما هو بقول شاعر. طيب, so number one, كلام الله. القرآن is the words of Allah سبحانه وتعالى. And also you find the scholars mentioning that also the other books, the words of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Tawrat and Injil. But what is the problem now? They claim this is the book of Allah, Injil. But actually they did not write the Injil from Isa alayhi salatu wasalam. They did not memorize the Injil. That's why يعني, there is a big difference between the Injil revealed to the Prophet Isa alayhi salatu wasalam and what they claim. They mention some stories and something, biography of someone from them, his students or students of his students. So for us as Muslims, we have to believe that the Quran, the words of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, al-munazzal, what does it mean, munazzal? Revealed. So which means Allah is high. And this is very clear from the Quran, وَبِالْحَقِّ أَنزَلْنَاهُ وَبِالْحَقِّ نَزَلْ. So Allah revealed the Quran. إِنَّا أَنزَلْنَاهُ. We read this Surah Al-Qadr. صح? إنا أنزلناه. We reveal that في ليلة القدر. So we say in the المنزل. So it is not there in the cave of Hira. No, Allah سبحانه وتعالى revealed this through جبريل عليه السلام. غير مخلوق, not created, and we mentioned this point. على محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم. The Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم. Allah revealed the book, his book, to his messenger Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم. So it was not revealed to Ali, to Abu Bakr, to Umar, to Aisha رضي الله تعالى عنهم أجمعين. No, none of them. It was revealed to the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم. So المنزل على محمد. Then he said المنقول إلينا بالتواتر, which came to us through تواتر. What does mean تواتر? If you remember, we mentioned this when we speak, when we studied the مصطلح الحديث, the science of hadith. Something متواتر الذي نقله جمع عن جمع تحيل تواطؤهم, تحيل عادة تواطؤهم على الكذب. A group conveyed the same message to the next group and they are not agreed. يعني it is impossible that they agree to lie. What is the meaning of that? We are here in the class. So someone came from Salwa. He said it is raining outside. Someone came from Mishrif. Someone came from Salmiya. Someone Jahra. So maybe 13, 14 brothers from different areas, all of them agree saying it is raining outside. So يعني what kind of belief you will have? For sure, this is right, not false. And it is impossible. They said that by mistake. If one of them came, maybe. Someone came, it is raining outside. Raining, okay. Maybe someone is washing the building from up and the water coming on his car. But 13, 14 from different areas and not the same time. Someone came 9, someone came 9:15. So this is the meaning of جمع and جمع, a group to another group. تُحِيلُ الْعَادَ تَوَاطُوهُمْ عَلَى الْكَذِبِ يعني which means it is impossible that they agree to lie. Because sometimes maybe it is possible that they agree to lie. How? Maybe they came, يعني for example, if 20 people came and they said the same thing, it is raining. But all of them came through one vehicle, one car. So there is possibility that they are lying, because if they should mention some excuse, otherwise I will punish them if I'm their teacher. So there is a strong possibility that they lie. صح? So what does it mean متواتر? Group to another group to حيل عاد تواطم على الكذب. So this is the meaning of متواتر. Then he said, المتعبد بتلاوته. What is the meaning of متعبد بتلاوته? That just reading it is عبادة, is a worship. When you read it, this is worship. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم إنا أعطيناك الكوثر فصل لربك وانحر إن شانئك ولابتر. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم إنا أعطيناك الكوثر. If you keep repeating the same surah for 70 times, 80, 90, just you are sitting like this from التراويح until فجر. This is عبادة and Allah will give you the reward. طيب. But if you read this definition, for example, definition of the Quran, what we say, كلام الله المنزل بالعربية غير مخلوق على محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم. If you repeat this 7 times, 10 times, you will not get the reward. Even if you read a hadith, قال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم إنما الأعمال بالنيات. قال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم إنما الأعمال. If you keep repeating إنما الأعمال بالنيات, okay, صلى الله عليه وسلم, you'll get the reward of saying the salah of the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم. But if you keep repeating إنما الأعمال بالنيات, إنما الأعمال بالنيات, no reward, just saying إنما الأعمال بالنيات. Okay, for example, if you claim that I am repeating to memorize, okay, you will get the reward of memorizing the hadith, but not reading the hadith every word. Sorry, every single letter you will get one hasana, then multiplied by 10. No, this is only for the Quran. And also you mentioned that, so this is the meaning of متعبد بتلاوته. This is the meaning of متعبد بتلاوته. And we mentioned also the definition بالعربية. So Quran, Arabic language, only the Arabic language. Not in English, Sinhali, Filipini, Thai, nothing like that. The Quran, the book of Allah, only in the Arabic language. But Sheikh, we have here, we have here in the Lajna. We have the Filipini Quran, we have the Tamil Quran, we have Hindi Quran. This is not Filipino Quran. If you check, it is written the translation of the meaning, not the Quran. It is wrong to say this is a translation of the Quran. Okay, because you know sometimes, because just to make it short, shortcut, we say, people say, well, I need Tamil Quran. I need, of course, this is wrong. This is wrong because there is no Tamil Quran. There is no French Quran. Impossible. This is impossible. What do we have? We have the translation of the meaning. Come on. Clear? Al-Mabdu' bil-Fatiha, Al-Mukhtatam bin-Nas. The Quran starts with Surah Al-Fatiha, ends with Surah An-Nas. So we it has a start and it has an end. So this is the definition of the Quran. Tayyib, sorry, I missed also the word Al-Mu'jiz. Al-Mu'jiz. What is the meaning of Al-Mu'jiz? Mu'jiz from the word Mu'jiza, miracle. Yes. What does it mean Mu'jiz? That it is impossible that you can say similar to it, something similar. Mu'jiz. You cannot say anything like the Quran. The information of the Quran, Mu'jiz. Everything is perfect in the Quran. Whatever we write, as a human being, we need to review. And we find some mistakes, then we change. Okay, yani, the school, books of the school. Every year, or maybe every 2 years, they change the books. Edition number 1, number 2, number 17, number 20, number... And every time they change, or maybe if they don't change, they change the next time, next year. What is the meaning that they are changing? Which means the book is not perfect. Because if it is perfect, they will not change anything. Okay? So this is the meaning of Al-Mu'jiz. This is the meaning of Al-Mu'jiz. Tamam? Okay, so please you repeat what we mentioned, definition.
It is the words of Allah,
Kalamullah.
It is revealed to Prophet Muhammad
Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam.
It is not created, غير مخلوق.
غير مخلوق.
It is متواتر.
متواتر.
When one reads it, it is worship. One reads it to worship.
Yes.
Quran was revealed only in the Arabic language. It starts from Fatiha and ends with An-Nas. It is Al-Mu'jiz, a miracle. No one can bring anything similar to it. It is perfect.
Yes, or even part of it. Allah said, فَلْيَأْتُوا بِعَشْرِ صُوَرٍ مِثْلِهِ مُفْتَرَيَاتٍ. Even 10 chapters. Yani Allah subhanahu challenged them with the full Quran. Allah challenged them with 10 chapters. One chapter. No one can do anything like the Quran. The book of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala revealed the Quran for what? Hidayah linnas, guidance. Allah revealed the Quran to have tadabbur, to reflect on the Quran. التدبر. Allah revealed the Quran شفاء. Okay, شفاء لما في الصدور وكذلك للأبدان. The Quran is a cure for the heart and for the body. يعني it is psychological medicine and also it is physical medicine. شفاء. And also the Quran is a proof that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, the messenger of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Al-Quran is the last book and the best book. ومهيمنا عليه and ناسخ. القرآن the last book, the best book, and it is مهيمن, which means ناسخ. يعني abrogated all the previous books. نسخ جميع الكتب السابقة. القرآن, الله سبحانه revealed the Quran in this month, رمضان, شهر رمضان الذي أنزل فيه القرآن. There is a hadith, Sheikh Al-Albani mentioned this hadith in Sahih Al-Jami'. In the hadith, the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم mentioned Allah revealed Sufah Ibrahim the first night, and Torah the sixth, Injil the 13, and Al-Quran 24, خلونا من رمضان. And Allah سبحانه وتعالى وأنزل القرآن لأربع وعشرين خلت من رمضان. 24, which means 24 nights finished from رمضان. Now here some scholars mention which means 25. What does it mean that 24 finished from رمضان? It means 25 night. Because Allah revealed the Quran night, not day. طيب, and majority of scholars say the meaning of أنزلناه في ليلة القدر, that Allah سبحانه وتعالى revealed the Quran to the first heaven in ليلة القدر, the whole Quran. Because the next point that Allah سبحانه وتعالى revealed the Quran within 23 years. Okay, what is the meaning that Allah revealed the Quran 23 years and Allah revealed the Quran ليلة القدر? So some scholars say, major scholars say, Allah revealed the full Quran to the first heaven in the night of decree. But the start or the beginning to reveal the Quran to the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, it was the night of القدر also. But no doubt the other Quran, the rest of the Quran, it was in Ramadan, Sha'ban, in the first year, the second year, within 23 years.
It was during the night time, all the
revelation. No, what do I mean that if we take the opinion of major scholars who said that Allah revealed the full Quran to the first heaven, this was at night. This was at night. Okay, but no doubt there is something we revealed, and during the day, اليوم أكملت لكم دينكم. This was in Arafah day. Yeah, like this. طيب, so Allah سبحانه وتعالى revealed the Quran. This goes say منجمًا. What does it mean منجمًا? Divided, not one time to the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم. One time to the first seven, but to the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم منجمًا within 23 years. What is the point of dividing the Quran or revealing the Quran during these 23 years? Number one, كذلك لنثبت به فؤادك, تثبيتا لقلب النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم, to frame the heart of the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم. Something happens, Allah reveals this ayah, so he will be comfortable and more firm صلى الله عليه وسلم. Another calamity, another ayat. So number one, تثبيتا لقلب النبي, to make the heart of the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم firm, and no doubt the believers with him. And also تجديد الوحي, يعني imagine if it came only once, then oh Muhammad, this is صلى الله عليه وسلم, this is the Quran, like Musa, Allah gave him the Torah. And the Jews, they asked the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, why the Quran is not coming to you once like the book of Musa, subhanallah. So تجديدا, يعني every time that the wahi is coming, every day or every other day, which means that there is support, and I am connected with Jibreel all the time. And also التدريج في التشريع. In Mecca, Allah did not mention that the khamr al-haram. Later in Medina, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned that there is harm and there is good, there is benefit, but the harm more than the benefit. Another ayah, don't approach the salah if you are drunk. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, fajtanibu, avoid it. Some rules for the divorce. Okay. Sorry, not the divorce, the widow. At the beginning, she should stay 1 year. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala made it 4 months and 10 days. Idda, the period for the woman, for the widow, after the death of her husband, it was 1 year to stay at home. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala changed it to four months and 10 days. How we have these rules? Because the Quran came gradually. And also other rules. Other rules. Jibreel alayhi salam used to come to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam during Ramadan to study with him the Quran. Every Ramadan, he used to study the Quran with the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, Jibreel. But the last Ramadan, he did that twice. He did that twice. And yeah, subhanAllah, hadith that Fatima radiallahu ta'ala anha was with the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and also Aisha was there. So Aisha radiallahu ta'ala noticed that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam told Fatima radiallahu ta'ala a secret. Then she cried. Then the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam told her another thing. She left. Yani, Aisha wonder, yani, this is something strange. Immediately you are crying, you are laughing, yani, the same time. The difference only a few seconds. Please, can you tell me? No, this is secret. Fatima radiallahu ta'ala said, no. Sir, hada sir. I cannot disclose the secret of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. After the death of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and as you know, the only child of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was after him, Fatima radiallahu ta'ala. She stayed about 6 months, then she passed away radiallahu ta'ala. And all of other his children passed away before him. Zainab, Ruqayya, Kulthum, Ibrahim, Abdullah, and Al-Qasim. All of them passed away before him, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So later, Aisha came. Can you remember that day? What did he inform you? She said that my father, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, told me that Jibreel used to study the Quran with me once in Ramadan. But this year, he did it twice. Which means this is my time, khalas. And you are the first, you are the first one to follow me. She cried. Then he told her, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, don't you like to be Sayyidat Nisa al-Jannah, the leader of the women in paradise? And she left. Tayyib, so Jibreel was studying the Quran with Jibreel, and he had this course. Said this means to, yani, to put the order of the Quran, because the order of the Quran that we have now from Surah Al-Fatiha, Surah Al-Baqarah, Surah Al-Imran, this is from the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam, from the Prophet. Tayyib. Because you know different opinions, is it from the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam or from the companions? Allah, and this is from the Prophet. This from the Prophet. The order that we have: Surah Al-Fatiha, Al-Baqarah, Al-Imran, Isa, Al-Ma'idah, Al-Na'am, like that until Al-Nas. This order from the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam.
Some of them sheikhs say it is from the time of Uthman radiallahu anhu. Is that true, or it's a weak?
No, this is not from Uthman. This is Wallahu A'lam, the stronger opinion. It is from the time of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. This is the time from the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam memorized the Quran. How? This is from Allah. As Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, Inna alayna jam'ahu wa Qur'ana. When Jibreel was coming to the Prophet ﷺ, teaching him the Quran or conveying to him the Quran, the Prophet ﷺ was repeating with Jibreel. And he was moving his lips quickly. Why? Because he wants to memorize. Usually when we want to memorize, we repeat. Right? So the Prophet ﷺ was repeating with Jibreel. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, لا تحرك به لسانك لتعجل به. Okay, don't move your tongue and your lips quickly. Don't worry. إن علينا جمعه وقرآنه. This is our job to keep the Quran in your heart. Don't worry. طيب. The Quran was written during the time of Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم. Maybe what is famous that the Quran was written during the time of Uthman. No, before the time of Uthman, also it was written during the time of Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم. And there are scholars of the companions who are writing the wahi, the revelation. Like Muawiyah, Ali, Abdullah ibn Amr al-As, radiallahu ta'ala anhum. They were writing the Quran. And the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, at the beginning, he said, لا تكتبوا إلا القرآن. Don't write except the Quran. At the beginning, he forbade them to write hadith. إنما الأعمال بالنيات, you want to write? No, it's forbidden. من كان يؤمن بالله واليوم الآخر no, don't write. If you like, you memorize. Writing the hadith, no, not allowed. Why the scholars, they said, والله أعلم, this was forbidden because at the beginning the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم once he wants the issue to be clear for the companions, the difference between Quran and hadith. Imagine if it was from the beginning, anything said by the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, they write. Then it will be mixed. They don't know the Quran and the hadith. But at the beginning, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam don't write except the Quran. Okay, what is the meaning of that? It means they will make sure. Oh, so this is Quran. Okay, this hadith we will not write. Later, Allah alam, maybe after 15 years, after 16 years, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam gave the permission to write hadith. Why? Because now it is clear for the companions what is the difference between the Quran. Not like now, we know the difference between the Quran and the hadith. يعني for example when I say وإذ قال ربك للملائكة إني جاعل في الأرض خليفة قال وتجعل فيها قرآن. This is clear for common people, the Muslims. And when I say من كان يؤمن بالله واليوم الآخر فليقل خيرا ويصمت. You have the feeling, the difference between the Quran and the Hadith, even if you don't memorize. For the Muslims, of course, يعني. I mean, الله أعلم, maybe even for the non-Muslims they can recognize by the miracle of the Quran. الله أعلم. طيب, so it was allowed, it was not allowed to write the hadith, only for the Quran. So the Sahaba wrote the Quran. Al-Usub, you know, they bring the leaf of a tree and they write. They don't have notebook, you don't have tablet, they don't have. So on the leaves, the bone of the camel, you know, the bone of the shoulder would be the scapula. Big for the human being, for us it is like the hand shape, size. For the camel it is bigger, so there is a space to write. You know the scapula? You can check in anatomy. It is in Arabic, it is called azmatul loh, subhanallah. Loh, you know the word loh? What does it mean, loh? The board.
The board,
this is loh. هذه we say the white board لوح. So subhanAllah, this bone, it is big, it is triangle shape, huh?
Shoulder blade.
Shoulder blade. Okay, so it is called scapula in anatomy. طيب, inshallah, if you study anatomy, you know. So subhanAllah, it is big. They write. طيب, Sheikh, is it allowed to write the Quran on najasa? Is it najis? It is, no, the point is not dry. The point, if it is slaughtered according to the Sharia, then it is tahir. But if it is dead, najis. If it is dead, najis. If you walk in this desert and you find a sheep or a camel, then this is najis. Dead camel, dead sheep. But for Eid al-Adha, we slaughter the sheep or camel, this is tahir, the skin, the bone, tahir, alhamdulillah. The whole body will be najis, the whole body. If you find something dead, the skin, the whole body. They can mention the exception that the hair, if you take the hair. And if you make tathir for the skin, But what is inside also najis. The bone, يعني depends. Is it a bone like the for the elephant? The knob, the big tooth, huh? Tusk.
Tusk.
Okay, this is different than the bone inside. But even يعني if we say this is dry, but still, the you know when the scholar says something najis and dry, okay, if you touch dry with the dry, the najas will not transmit. But if it is wet, it will go. It will go. So the Quran was written. The Quran was written, but here and there. Tamam? And it was not organized. They mentioned it was there in the house of Aisha radiallahu ta'ala anha. Then during the time of Abu Bakr, something called the day of Al-Yamama. In that day, that battle, 70 of the Qurra were killed. 70 of the Qurra were killed. Then Umar radiallahu ta'ala an went to Abu Bakr radiallahu telling him, oh Abu Bakr, يعني, it's serious that we lost 70 of the Qurra. Let's gather the Quran. Abu Bakr at the beginning was not convinced. I cannot do something not done by the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. But Umar told him, now 70 killed and we don't know what's happened. So he was talking to him until he accepted that idea. Then he called Zayd ibn Thabit. Zayd ibn Thabit or Zayd ibn Haritha? No. Zayd Thabit, because Zayd ibn Haritha killed radiallahu ta'ala as a martyr in which battle? Mu'ta. Mu'ta. Zayd ibn Haritha, Abdullah ibn Rawaha, and Ja'far ibn Abi Talib in the 8th year. So the same thing. How can I do this? Then Abu Bakr was telling him until he accepted that. And he said, yani, why Allah, if they tell me to carry a mountain from one place to another place, it will be easier than gathering the Quran. So Zayd ibn Thabit worked hard to gather the Quran, radiallahu ta'ala an, to bring the paper from here, from there. And he was making sure with the written with the memorized. The written with the memorized. And he likes two witnesses for everything written. And they mentioned that, subhanAllah, for one ayah, من المؤمنين رجال صدقوا ما عاهدوا الله فمن من قضى نحبه. He did not find a shahid. He did not find a witness. Then he found Khuzaymah ibn Thabit. And he did not find the second witness, but he accepted him. Why? Because the Prophet made his shahada for two people. Equals to two people. Why? Because something happened during the time of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, alaykum salam, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam had an issue with one of the Bedouin or someone, and that man denied something, and he told the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, bring a witness. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam doesn't have a witness. Then Khuzaymah Thabit came, or is an eyewitness. The Prophet said, but you did not attend there during the transaction. How come you are giving the witness, the shahada? He said, oh Rasulullah, I'm giving you the shahada because you are Rasulullah and you don't lie. So that's why the Prophet gave him the shahada of two people. So for that ayah, Zayd ibn Thabit accepted Khuzaymah ibn Thabit radiallahu ta'ala an. And the second time there was gathering of the Mus'haf during the time of Uthman radiallahu ta'ala an. So the Quran written and memorized. The Quran written and memorized. Maktub fi al-sutur wa mahfuz fi al-sudur. Written fi al-sutur, the lines. Written on lines of the book, and mahfud, memorized inside the hearts or the chests. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, بَلْ هُوَ آيَاتٌ بَيِّنَاتٌ فِي صُدُورِ الَّذِينَ أُوتُوا الْعِلْمِ. Subhanallah, sometimes very simple, straightforward issues, but you'll find people denying and playing with us. Why? Because you'll find many Muslims listen to them. This is the problem. The ignorance. Because of the ignorance, you'll find the deviant people spreading their doubts. مشكلة. Very simple things. Today someone, I don't know this brother. Okay, he sent me a video. Sheikh, please, we should stop this video or this channel. Yeah, sorry, I did not get his point. He means that because it was a conversation between a Christian and a Muslim. But I think he means also the Muslim, he is a deviant Muslim. And discussing with this. So I watched short time from the video. This Christian, he's quoting from the Quran. Look, in the Quran, you have وَرُوحٌ مِّنْ about Isa عليه الصلاة والسلام. Look, the translation, and he quote maybe 3-4 translations of the Quran. The meaning of the Quran. Look, he is a spirit from Allah. Yallah, the first one, the first ayah, the second ayah. Subhanallah. And for us, for Muslims, it is very easy. That basically, we believe that Isa alayhi salatu wasalam, قال إني عبد الله, I am the slave of Allah. We believe that Isa alayhi salam is the son of Maryam. Straightforward, خلاص, we learned that story, and it is logic. But what is not logic to claim that Isa alayhi salam is part of God, or he is God, or he the Trinity. How is God and they killed him? How? Where is your logic? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, قُلْ هُوَ اللَّهُ أَحَدٌ. So what do I mean? There are straightforward issues, but it is straightforward for the Muslim who has the basics. But when the Muslim is away from the Quran and Sunnah, you'll find him confused. Those who watch the videos, okay, the debates, Sheikh, I watch a video and there is one Sheikh debating with a Christian monk and he could not answer. And you find people are confused. Why? Because they jumped for these debates. They don't study pillars of Iman, pillars of Islam. So, Al-Quran mahfuz wa maktub, memorized and written. And there are many of the companions memorized the Quran. Okay, what is the meaning that during the time of Abu Bakr, 70 were killed? Which means there are many companions memorized the Quran. Like Uthman, Muawiyah, Ubay, Ali, Zayd, Abdullah ibn Sa'd, Nabi Sar, and others, radiallahu ta'ala, anhum ajma'in. So Zayn Thabit, he gathered the Mus'haf and he put it with Abu Bakr, then after Abu Bakr, Umar, then after Umar, Hafsa, then after Hafsa, Uthman radiallahu ta'ala. So during the time of Uthman, what happened? There was like a start. It was not a fight, but Uthman feared a fight will happen because of the Quran. Because Allah subhanahu revealed the Quran, 7 ahraf, according to 7 letters, 7 different ways. So Uthman radiallahu ta'ala came to know that some Muslims started to fight or to debate. So what he did, he told them to burn all the Quran and to follow the Quran that he gathered for them. And that's why it is called Mus'haf al-Uthmani. Al-Uthmani. So he told them to burn all the Mus'haf and to depend on the Mus'haf that I'm sending. He sent 4 copies, yani one to Sham, one to Baghdad, something like that, and the nation 7. طيب. When they wrote the Quran, it was without tashkil, without the dots, without tashkil, fatha, dhamma. Why? Because it was not needed that time. It was not needed. And they have, okay, Sheikh, how it is not needed? How can they differentiate between, sometimes words, we can't differentiate with the fatha kasra. No, they have their way to differentiate. And for example, the word fi'a. Fi'a, fa, kas, hamza, ala nabira, ta marbuta. طيب في قلم ذي الاسبن ها bring the whiteboard. طيب يعني فئة كان or I should pull it okay فئة ومئة فئة means a group فئة means 100 ها مئة منو okay leave this okay so now without letter without فتحة وضمة almost the same طيب so now how to differentiate this is فئة and مئة how to write مئة they will write it like this okay they put ألف to differentiate between مئة and فئة so now no need to write مئة like this and you'll find people because now in the books they write مئة like this right and they, you'll find many people what do they say ماء حبيبي this is wrong and the problem when you find someone who's giving جمعة خطبة saying ماء this is wrong because in Arabic in the grammar which is stronger the ألف or the كسرة or the كرسي but they say ماء not مئة طيب and also عمر and عمر عمر they are the same how to differentiate between عمر and عمر like عمر الخطاب عمر بن العاص واو they put واو so this is عمر عم there is no فتحة كسرة but they know so the common mistake now they call عمرو wrong he is عمر طيب so now خلاص no need for this عمر so at the beginning so at the beginning the companions know they know but later يعني إذا جاء نصر الله والفتح ورأيت الناس يدخلون في دين الله أفواج many Muslims entered Islam or from the east from the south everywhere طيب Arabs and non-Arabs so problem now how to make it clear for them so they started the نقط during the time of Bani Umayya عبد الملك ابن مروان the fifth Khalifa of the Bani Umayya okay so because of the need they put the dots the dots and the fatha kasra and these things sorry they put the dots like the nuqta for noon two nuqta for ta and for the fatha dhamma this is later during the Abbasi time during the Abbasi time by they mentioned this was done by Khalil ibn Ahmed al-Farahidi Khalil ibn Ahmed al-Farahidi طيب تقسيم القرآن how to divide the Quran now when you open the مصحف how do you find the Quran the divisions of the Quran of the chapters how حزب and جزء 30 جزء 30 parts and 60 حزب but actually this was not from the time of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam from the time of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam شوف there is a حديث شيخ الباني رحمه الله مش الصحيح الجامع من صحيح الجامع أعطيت مكان التوراة I was giving instead of the Torah السبع الطوال and I was giving مكان الزبور المئين مئين from the word 100 and I was giving instead of the إنجيل المثاني وفضلت بالمفصل and the preference for me مفصل so what do you notice here the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم divided the Quran السبع الطوال المئين المثاني المفصل this is the way because يعني سبحان الله also يعني so this is the sunnah and this is the logic you read the full surah but now when you read the Quran now in Ramadan يعني what we do every day one juz you have to make it easy طيب but try to make it so according to the surah so maybe the first day you read سورة البقرة the second day سورة آل عمران okay it will be more at the beginning but later it will be less because يعني where you stopped according to the حزب أتأمرون الناس بالبر إن الله لا يستحي أن يضرب مثلا مع so sometimes it is in between the meaning so the تقسيم the Quran according to the parts not from the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم and you are not obliged to follow that But the scholars made this to make it easy. يعني 30 parts, 60 حزب, like that. Which حزب and every حزب four quarters, like that. But no doubt, when you pray, when you read, you follow the full surah. You follow the full surah. And المئين, which means the surah. More than 100 ayah. And the Quran should not be read in less than 3. The Prophet ﷺ told Amr As, read the Quran 1 month. Oh, so I have power. I have time. So the sunnah, the general sunnah, we read the Quran within 1 month. Okay, to read it within 1 month, it doesn't mean that every day one juz. So maybe when you read the hadith, you understand that every day should be one juz. Every day should be equal. And this is, يعني, if you remember, we mentioned this in the Sifat Salat Nabi, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, that you'll find the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, his tahajjud goes gradual. He will not pray the same thing. Why? Because yeah, this is the sunnah of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and also this goes with the psychology of the person. يعني imagine that when I go to a masjid and they pray the first two rak'ah and the first two rak'ah and sorry in every rak'ah they read 4 pages. So for sure my power at the beginning not like my power at the end. It will be less. So imagine that I know the imam is following the sunnah. So the first rak'ah 4 pages. Then 3.5. Then 3. Then 2.5. What do you يعني psychological will be easier. This will be easier. طيب. So subhanAllah, when we say that you read the Quran within 1 month, it doesn't mean necessarily that every day you read one part, you read the same amount of Quran. Not necessary. If you read, okay, no problem at all. طيب. But no doubt, it's better that you read according to the surah. According to the surah. Yes. One point. The word mushaf. Is it bid'ah يعني or from the sunnah? It is there in the sunnah, the word mushaf. Yes, it was not, I mean, the full mushaf was not there during the time of Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم. But the concept was there. يعني we have the hadith, the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم said, من سر أن يحب الله ورسوله فليقرأ في المصحف. The one who likes, the one who wants to love Allah and his messenger, let him read from the mushaf. And also, it is not allowed to travel with the Mus'haf to the non-Muslim country or to the enemy country. So I mean, the word Mus'haf was there. It is not bid'ah. It is there from the Sunnah of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. At that time, what were they referring to as Mus'haf? Allah, maybe the Prophet knows that people will gather the mushaf in a place, because during the time of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, for sure the mushaf was not gathered. And this is also, yes, one of the point why the mushaf was not there during the time of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Number one, because the Prophet ﷺ did not tell them to gather mushaf. Number two, because they don't know the end of the wahi. They don't know the death of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. So because they don't know the end of the wahi, so that's why they did not gather the mushaf. But wallah alam, the Prophet ﷺ knows that it will be in the future mushaf. طيب, there is a concept مكي ومدني. There is a concept مكي ومدني. What does it mean مكي ومدني? There is one opinion, مكي which is revealed in Mecca, and مدني which is revealed in Medina. Another definition, and maybe Allah Alam, this is a stronger opinion, which says the مكي which was revealed before Hijra, مدني after Hijra. So the first definition according to the place, the second according to the time. And this is stronger, wallahu alam. Why? Because if we take the first one, Allah said, "Al-yawma akmaltu lakum dinakum." Allah revealed this ayah in the 10th year in Mecca or in Arafah. So this is Makki or Madani. So it is Madani. It is Madani because of the time, not because of the place. So what is the point to know Makki or Madani? Number one, to know an-nasikh wal-mansukh. This is also one of the points I'll mention later, that there is something very important when you study the Quran or the Sunnah, I mean generally Islam, you should know an-nasikh wal-mansukh, the abrogation. طيب, what is the main thing to know an-nasikh wal-mansukh? The time. If you don't know the time, you cannot decide. And one of the main things to help you, Makki, Madani. This was revealed in Mecca, this was revealed in Medina. طيب. So المكي والمدني, مكي والمدني. So yes, it helps you for تدبر. It helps you for تدبر. Reflect on the Quran. And also for the fiqh is very important. For the fiqh is very important. Yeah, like now, the scholars mentioned that for this country or for this people, the Muslim community in the non-Muslim country, they should follow the rules or the way of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam when he was in Mecca. So how can you decide for them? According to the Makki and Madani. And also, the rules was gradual, not came as one set. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala revealed the Quran gradually, and the rules gradually. Like, what do you notice in Makki and Madani? When you come to the Makki surah, you notice the short ayat, short verses. You notice short ayat. عَمَّ يَتَسَالُونَ عَنِ النَّبِيِّ الْعَظِيمِ الَّذِي هُمْ فِيهِ مُخْتَلِفُونَ كَلَّا سَيَعْلَمُونَ. So in one line, you notice three or four ayat. While Madani, usually, long. لم يكن الذين كفروا من أهل الكتاب المشركين منفكين حتى تأتيهم بينة. This is جزء عما. الله لا إله إلا هو الحي القيوم لا تأخذه سنة. Maybe four, five lines. آية الدين, one page. So when you notice the Makki's آيات short, generally, not all of them, but generally. مدني آيات long. Another point, the rules of fiqh more in the مدني. While in Makki you'll find the Aqidah issues. The Aqidah, the stories of the Prophets alayhi salatu wasalam, talk about paradise and the hellfire where? In the Makki surah. And of course the Tawheed. So you'll find the difference between the Makki surah and the Madani surah. طيب, when you come to the issue of Asbab al-Nuzul, Asbab al-Nuzul. You should know maybe most of the Quran we don't know Asbab al-Nuzul. Why Allah subhanahu revealed this ayah? Allahu alam. Yani if you go and you buy a book about Asbab al-Nuzul, you'll find the books. Yani there is a book by Sheikh Muqbil al-Hadi, rahimullah, Sahih al-Musnad bin Asbab al-Nuzul. Yes, the book, I think 250 something like this, but it is 250 because he mentioned the Sanad. But imagine if you remove the Sanad, if you remove the chain of narrators, maybe the book will be 100 pages. So most of the ayat we don't know. Right? So this is one point. What is the benefit of studying Asbab al-Nuzul? Number one, to understand the ayat. Number two, to know the ahkam, the rules. And also to remove any doubt. Because sometimes when you read the ayah, yeah, and what is the meaning of this ayah? But when you know the sabab, you will understand. Khalas, it will clear your doubt. So this is يعني أسباب and of course يعني as we mentioned like الناسخ منسوخ this you'll find books about الناسخ منسوخ you'll find books about أسباب النزول and also you'll find books about writing the Quran نقط النقط and these things. The also one of the points that the Quran has many names الذكر القرآن الكريم or القرآن العظيم الفرقان الكتاب many books. طيب. Something important as something practical to learn the Quran. يعني شوفوا as we mentioned at the beginning that علوم القرآن includes all everything related to the Quran. You have something استماع, something تلاوة, something حفظ, something تدبر and عمل. Again. Our relationship with the Quran. Number one, الاستماع. What does it mean استماع? You tell someone to read or you start your the radio and you hear استماع. You hear and listen. This is one level or one type. Another type, التلاوة. You read. So, and you'll find the Prophet ﷺ for sure. He was reading Quran. And also, he told Abdullah Mas'ud, read the Quran because I like to hear it from others. Number three, al-hifz, memorizing the Quran. Memorizing the Quran. Number four, tadabbur, to reflect on the Quran. And number five, al-amal. Number four, to reflect. Number five, to act upon the Quran. So about istima, وَإِذَا قُرِيَ الْقُرْآنَ فَاسْتَمِعُوا لَهُ وَأَنصِتُوا. Number one. Number two, الذين آتيناهم الكتاب يتلونه حق تلاوته. Number three, الحفظ, memorizing. بل هو آيات بينات في صدور الذين أوتوا العلم. What does it mean? It is inside their chest. Memory, memorization. Number four, تدبر. كتاب أنزلناه إليك مبارك ليدبروا. Number five, الذين يستمعون القول فيتبعون أحسن. They follow the best. Which means they act upon the Quran. Wallahi, this is very important. So now we mentioned these five points and the proofs from the Quran. You will not find something that to hang the Quran on the wall. Nothing. Or to Sheikh, is it okay we write Allahu la ilaha illa huwa here? The woman, the necklace. Nothing in the Quran like that. The Quran is not to beautify your chest, your neck, your arm. The Quran to beautify your heart. So the Quran is not for the walls. This is wallahi a common mistake. And unfortunately we find this in many of our masajid. Yani almost, Allahu a'lam, maybe most of our masajid. Or many of the masajid. Yani at least you will find them writing one ayah. كلما دخل عليها زكريا المحراب وجد عندها رزقا. Or وأن المساجد لله فلا تدعو مع الله أحد. Okay, sometimes nice, no doubt. يعني nice that وأن المساجد لله that you should be sincere when you pray. The message should be for the sake of Allah. Okay, nice, but this is not the sunnah. You write the Quran on the walls. تمام؟ So this is very important. And I will end with this point, inshallah. Quickly, I go through Adab al-Quran, Adab al-Quran, because we are in the month of Ramadan. The whole year, of course, we need these Adab. Some manners of the Quran. Number one, al-ikhlas, sincerity. Number two, al-khushu', yani, like focus and concentration with tranquility. Number three, التدبر المعاني. To reflect on the Quran, and of course, to reflect on the Quran, you need to understand. Number four, الطهارة, to be in a state of purity. Number five, siwak, clean your mouth. Number six, face the qibla, استقبل القبلة, if it is possible. Number seven, to react with the Quran. To act different than to react. To react, if you remember, we mentioned many times when the Prophet ﷺ recited قُلُوا وَالْقَادُرُ عَلَىٰ يَبْعَثَ عَلَيْكُمْ عَذَابٍ مِنْ فَوْقِكُمْ. He said, I seek refuge by your face, O Allah. With your face, O Allah. So, this means you understand. You react with the Quran. This is important. التجاوب مع القرآن. There should be a reaction. Number eight, تحلي بأخلاق القرآن. To follow the morals of the Quran. The Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, Aisha رضي الله عنه, described the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم by saying, كان خلقه القرآن. His behavior, Quran. Do you like to know the behavior and the attitude of Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم? Read the Quran. You'll find his behavior. Number nine, استعادة and بسملة. استعادة and بسملة, except for Surah Tawbah without بسملة. But if you start from the middle of the surah, only isti'adah. Number 10, repeating the ayat sometimes. Also, the Prophet ﷺ repeated. Okay, maybe you focus on an ayah, you repeat. No problem, you repeat. This is a sign of concentration of and your tadabbur. Number 11, you read according to the ma'na, the meaning. As we mentioned, the point of the ajza, the parts. Okay, you read and you stop in any place. Wallah, I stop. Ayah number 100. Okay, Habib, but you are at the beginning of the story. Finish the story or you should stop before the story. So try to follow the meanings. Number 12, tartil al-Quran haqqa tilawa, which means to follow the rules of tajweed. Try your best. Yani, it should not be equal to newspaper or the magazine. The Quran should be different. There are special rules for the Quran tajweed. Follow the rules of Quran. Number 13, احترام القرآن. Respect the Quran. Respect the Quran. يعني for example, you have, this is the Mus'haf. Don't put your book, the school, or the hadith book on the Quran. Respect the Quran. The Quran should be on top of all of them. You should not keep the Quran. You know, sometimes you notice some people, the Quran in the car. طيب, after some time, swelling. Why? Because it is in the sun. 4 or 5 days. Respect the Quran. Why keep it outside? يعني if you are not using the Quran, give it to someone to use the Quran, to read the Quran, or يعني put it in a respectful place. You should respect the Quran. Also in the masjid, يعني don't put your feet. You know, sometimes you find people, they put their feet toward the Quran. No, you should respect that. Don't take the Quran inside the toilet. Okay? Toilet is not a nice place. So you should respect the Quran. So generally, you respect the Quran. And of course, when you hear the Quran, you listen. When you hear the Quran, you listen. Also, one of the manners, to read from the Quran. You know, we mentioned the hadith. مَنْ سَرَّ وَنْ يُحِبَّ اللَّهُ رَسُولَهُ. If you like to love Allah and His Messenger, read from the Quran. Because, you know, this is what, yani, the scholars mentioned, which is better, you read from your memory or from the Mus'haf? You'll find some scholars saying that you read according to the way you feel the khushu'. But you know, we have this hadith tells us it's better to read from the Mus'haf. Don't ignore the Mus'haf. And also one of the manners to believe in what is the Quran. What is the point that you read the Quran and you don't believe in it? Or you don't agree with some of the points? This is wrong. Major mistake. You should follow the Quran also. And also one of the manners of the Quran, don't say, I forgot this ayah. Don't. I was forgotten. Unsitu. أو أسقطته. It should be in passive. Don't say I forgot this ayah. The Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم said لا يقول أحدكم أو بئس يقول أحدكم أنا نسيت. What a bad statement saying I forgot. No, don't say I forgot. I was forgotten. تمام؟ So these are some of the أخلاق or manners of the Quran. إن شاء الله أستوب هنا. جزاكم الله خيرا. صلي الله وسلم على محمد.